I sometimes don't even know that he knew how good he was. It's almost like every once in a while, he would just decide he was going to dominate a shift or dominate a game.
Here's a breakaway chance. Fedorov bearing in. Score!
Sergei would have a quiet game going on, and then all of a sudden he would decide, you know, pick the puck up from behind our net and go coast to coast and score a goal. We're like, why didn't you do that, like, at the beginning of the period, you know?
When he decided that it was time to play, there wasn't too many things or too many people that could stop Sergei Fedorov.
In the fourth round of the 1989 NHL entry draft, the Detroit Red Wings drafted Russian-born Sergei Fedorov. A star in the Soviet hockey program, Fedorov was excited by the chance to thrill large NHL crowds, and he defected to join the Red Wings.
When he came over, he was unbelievable. Yeah. Sergei was awesome. Skate, pass, shoot.
He had an unbelievable wrist shot. He had an unbelievable one-timer. He could beat you one-on-one.
Probably one of the most talented guys I've ever played with in my life.
Head coach Scotty Bowman maximized Fedorov's effectiveness when he composed the Russian Five, a five-man unit of Soviet-born players that shared a unique on-ice chemistry.
They were awesome. I mean, nobody had seen that kind of hockey before.
This is Lariano as they weave and circle. There's Konstantinov, one touch.
We know most of the Russian players are so good offensively. He worked on his defense all the time. He wanted to be a good checking player.
Sergei Fedorov continues to be a force. That's the classic sweep check.
Fedorov's offensive flair and defensive ability were rewarded in 1993-94 when he scored a career-high 56 goals en route to winning the Hart Trophy, Pearson Award, and Selke Trophy.
Sergei is one of the most skilled, complete players that I witnessed.
The flashy Fedorov also continued to flourish defensively, winning a second Selke in 96. And when injuries plagued the Red Wings, he filled in as a defenseman.
Why Sergei? Well, because he can do it. His approach was unorthodox, to say the least. You think of a defenseman, he's backing up one-on-one, he's got to stick out the hand up. I mean, there's times where Sergei was skating forwards, but he got the job done.
His skill and versatility helped the Red Wings win back-to-back Stanley Cups in 1997 and 98. And a third in 2002.
In my wildest dreams, I would never expect something like that.
He went on to become the first Russian-born player to score 1,000 points in the NHL, retiring in 2009 as the all-time leading Russian scorer.
I accept this honor today. And I will proudly wear this ring and this blazer as an ambassador to the game I love, the game of hockey.